There are many use cases where you'll need to collect signatures in a form. Sometimes you need to store that signature, sometimes you need to create some sort of a document. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do all of that and more. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the most out of your no-code tools so that you can build amazing solutions and reclaim your time. As I mentioned in this video, we're going to be taking a look at how you can collect signatures using a form made by Fillout, and we're going to store that information back in Airtable. But before we get to the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is where you're going to learn how to really reclaim your time, and it doesn't matter what tool you're building automation in, they all work the same, and I break it down for you in my free training that you can grab at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Sign up for free, get instant access to that training, but without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things and check out how we can collect signatures in Fillout. Now, first, we're going to open up Fillout. If you don't already have an account, go ahead and use the link that I'll share with this video. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel, and we really appreciate it. Once you're inside a Fillout, you can go ahead and make a Fillout. This is basically making a form, and we're going to start from scratch with a blank form. You can choose your theme over here, and I'll go with formal gray, and we'll go ahead and create this form. Now, when we start it off, we're going to be asked to name the form. I'll call this signature collection, and we will continue. And now we start bringing the elements into the form. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is just collect some high-level data. Let's get name and email in here. So for name, I'm going to use short answer, and I'll type this to say your name here. And then we're going to also look for the email field type. Now, if you don't want to scroll through all of this, just go up to search fields and look for the type of data you're looking to collect and type it in there. Here's my email, and I can redo this on the form to say your email. Now, I have a lot of options in here that I'm not going to cover in this video, things like requiring these fields, things like changing them to be half width. Check out our other videos on Fillout if you're interested in that. Where I want to really focus right now is bringing in the signature component. So back up here again, I'm going to go up to searching fields and look for signature and drop it in right here. And so we can go your signature, and we are now good. So on the signature itself, I want to first point out that there are a number of different options for you down here in the display. By default, you're going to get the ability to do a little signature on the form itself. That one we cannot toggle on or off, but there are two options that you can toggle off if you want. The first one is the upload option, and the second one is the typing option. I'll show you both of those when we actually go into the form itself. Let's keep them toggled on for now. Just keep it in the back of your mind that you can always come back here, toggle them off if you don't like them. Now, once we're done building our form, let's preview it. This is where we're going to showcase. This is what the end user is going to see on desktop and on mobile. It looks just like this. And they will type in their information, their email, and then go to add the signature. Now, here is drawing. This is the default type for any signature, but we can also type it in. So they can just come in and type in their name. Looks a lot better, at least for me. I can never get the signature to draw right. They can choose from some different fonts as well, however they want their signature to show up. And then also you can go with the upload option. If they have a version of their signature on their desktop or computer, they can just drag it in here and upload it right here to the form and then click done. So for me, I'm just going to go with typing. Let's click done and we will submit. And then that's going to collect in the form. Now the big question is, what are you going to do with this information? You want to store it back in Airtable? Let's talk about options. So first, let's exit preview. Now we're going to flip into Airtable, and we're going to look at storing this data back here. So I've built a really simple table where I'm storing the name and the email address. Notice that these field types are the same type of data. So we're collecting a string of text or a single line here. We're collecting here email addresses. And here, I'm going to upload the signature itself. This is the actual thing that they scribble out or type out, and I'm using an attachment field type. Now we're going to pop back into Fillout. We're going to go over to integrations and we're going to integrate it with Airtable. So if we have multiple Airtable accounts, go ahead and choose the one that you're using here and now connect your base. So here I have the Fillout signatures base that I have back in Airtable. And where do you want to store this information? It can only be to one table. We are going to store it in our signatures table, as you probably would have guessed. Now we're going to create a new record upon form submission. There are more advanced options in Fillout where you can actually update existing records, which we're not going to get into for this purpose. But here we go down to mappings. And this is where we're going to say when certain data is filled out on a form, it's going to map to a specific place in that table. So back here in Airtable, we've got, remember, name, email, signature. So back here in Fillout, we're going to look for those three fields. Here is name. And this is the field in Fillout in the form that's going to get mapped there. So your name here was what we called that. We have email that we want to map to. But most importantly, we're looking at that third component, the actual signature itself. So we have the signature field. Remember, it's an attachment field type. We select the your signature element in the form, and it's going to get mapped directly to Airtable. Let's finish our setup and actually take this form out for a quick spin. We'll publish it and we will go ahead and open this up in a new window. This is exactly what our end users are going to see when they access this. So again, they can type this out. I'll just actually use the signature this time, fill out some stuff. Let's say done, and we submit. Now this information that easily is automatically mapped to Airtable. So if I flip in here to Airtable, you see we just received that information directly from Fillout. This is the information, this stuff, not so mind-blowing, but the signature, this is the moneymaker right here. We're actually capturing that information and we can see the signature as a, you know, image that's actually stored here. But this is not your only option. This is just the beginning. You might want to actually take that signature and map it onto a PDF. So what I've done for our example here is created this really simple PDF, and we're going to actually map this data onto the PDF, specifically the signature, and then we can actually store the output of this PDF back to Airtable. So how are we going to do that? Well, let's flip back now to Fillout, and we're going to go to our integrations here, and instead of integrating directly to Airtable, we are going to generate a PDF, and we can drop our PDF in over here. I just have mine on the desktop on another screen. The upload is complete. That's my PDF. I can add fields, drag them down here, and then map these fields to information on the form. So on our form, we had the signature, right? We're collecting this field. And now when we're done and the form is submitted, we're going to plug the signature into our PDF and generate a PDF upon submission. So let's go ahead and save this up and click out of the integration now. And we can delete our Airtable integration if we want to. And now we're going to create that PDF automatically. Now, before I publish the changes, I actually want to add an element to the form. Maybe I want the person who submits the form to be able to download the very PDF themselves. Check this out. On my ending page, I can come down here and there's an option to bring in the download your PDF. So this is available because of the fact that I have now created a PDF with the form submission. So now I'm saying, hey, you submitted the form, and on the final page, you're going to get the option to download the document that you just created. So let's publish these changes. We'll flip back now into the form itself. We'll fill out our information one more time. And you can see, oh, nicely, it's already remembered this. Let me go ahead and add my signature one more time, and we'll say done. When we submit, we're taken to our ending page, and we can now download our PDF just like that. Let's go ahead and open up that PDF now, and you can see that we mapped the signature that I just dropped into the form directly here. Now, as I mentioned, we can actually save this whole PDF now that we've created back in Airtable and do whatever we want with it from there. So in order to do that, let's build another Airtable integration. We're going to connect it to our Airtable account again, select the base, select the table, just as we did the first time. But this time we're going to map to our PDF field. Note in Airtable that I have another field here, also an attachment field. And from here, I'm just going to say, rather than selecting elements from the form itself, we're going to go down to this little icon for documents and bring in the entire document that we create. Let's finish the setup, publish the changes, and take this out one more time to confirm that it works. I'll add my information one more time, email, name, signature, done, click on submit, flip back into Airtable now. Note that I could have downloaded the document at the end, but you'll see that we just created a new record and it created the PDF, including our signature from the form. Now, as a closing thought, I do want to point out that I'm not a lawyer and I don't know the first thing about making something legally binding. That is not my area of expertise, but Fillout has us covered. So you can go ahead and swing by their very popular blog post about this very thing, how to make eSign compliant signed agreements and contracts. And they break it all down here, you know, a little bit of background, a little bit of history, and then what's required for an electronic signature. There are different components that you'll want to add, including a checkbox that says that people realize that this is a legally binding contract, etc. So go ahead and read through this. I will include a link to this blog wherever you found this video so that you can check it out to make sure that you are in compliance with whatever laws you might need for work agreements, contracts, etc. on your fill-out forms. Really powerful stuff, and I know we went really quickly here, so any questions you have, feel free to swing by our website and explore the different resources we've put together and reach out if you're still stuck. That's it for this video. If you got some value from it, please give us a thumbs up, and in the meantime, keep on building.